Everybody, it's Lance coming to you from Austin, Texas once again with my good friend Kurt Cole. Hey, Kurt.
Hey.
I met the folks at Brown Amplification at the Dallas Guitar Show. Small, little company, little family-owned company in Texas. And I stopped by the booth because they looked really cool. And I thought, well, you know, let me give this thing a run, right? It's, you know, and I thought, oh no, here's another guy making some of the EL34s. Oh Lord, here we go. But actually, this is really interesting and it's different. And I wanted to do a demo for him because I think this is a really cool flexible amp that a lot of you guys might like, okay? So let me tell you a little bit about it. Over here we have a clean channel, which you were just hearing. It's very simply laid out. Okay, you got your bass, mid, treble, gain, and volume. And here is your second channel, which has volume, stacked gains, a contour control that does sort of changes the harmonic balance of the amp a little bit. It's more of a feel thing than anything else, right? And then you got your bass, mid, and treble. Now on the back, you have a very cool effects loop that has a send and return. And I wish more amp companies would do that, because the great thing about that is you can actually use pedal effects, rack effects, balance your ins and outs. And then there's this neat trick you can also do if you don't have any effects in the loop at all, you can use it as a boost. So what you're doing is you're setting that input and output gain almost like a second channel, which can work on either the gain channel or the clean channel. So you heard what the clean channel sounded like. It's pretty, right? It's nice sounding. Here it is, the neck position, right? Bridge again. But now watch this. I'm gonna hit that loop. I'm turning that loop on, and you're gonna get what I think sounds more like sort of your Dave Grissom level of gain from like a 50 watt Marshall, right? Right?
Heck yeah.
Cool. So let's look at the second channel. Second channel, I've got it set up a little dirty. Let me see how this works. Nice, right?
Yeah.
And you can dink around a lot, like turning these gains down. You got almost like a blues amp, right? Turn the first stack gain up. That's kind of a cool blues, you know, slightly broken up blues tone, right?
Love it.
And then you pull that second gain up and you get. And even more gain, and we're still talking about a Telecaster here. This isn't a high gain guitar. Fun?
Yeah.
Right, and let's turn the boost on. Okay, so I'd like to switch now and show you what it sounds like with a humbucker guitar. And we're back. And you know, this week and last week we've been featuring the incredible 1957 Les Paul that belongs to good old Dr. Mike in Denver, Colorado. Refin top, Grovers, but those are pre-serial number Grovers on it. It's got the original pickups and everything. Sounds great. Great sounding guitar. I've been borrowing it. Thank you, Dr. Mike. And here is this Les Paul through the Brown Amps clean channel. Neck and Bridge. And boosted. Lots of fun, okay? And Kurt pointed something out on the break when I was grabbing the Les Paul. This amp just isn't spiky sounding. It's you know, it's what you were saying. I mean, it's got,
that's right.
It's got plenty of top end, but it's got that kind of top end that's sweet where you can turn the amp up and you don't get ear fatigue. It doesn't have that ugly, brash thing going. It's a very, very warm amp, hence the name Brown.
Now, yeah, I was wondering about that.
Well, it's actually, his last name is Brown, believe it or not, but certainly works, right? So I'm gonna show you the gain channel with a humbucker. Oh my God. Contra control is interesting, right?
I just had that moment where I thought, I gotta get one of those.
Yeah. Okay, look. We're still making a video. I was like all off into playing the amp, right?
Yeah.
Look, this thing, it feels fast under your fingers. It doesn't sound hard. You get tweak those two gain knobs on the gain channel and just get all kinds of sounds. Now, look, I don't know what this guy's doing with his circuit, and I don't have to know. I just know it sounds great. It's almost as fast as a train wreck under my fingers. And it's got a whole separate clean channel, which, you know, you can go back and forth, or you could live in the clean channel and use gain pedals if you wanted to. A lot of guys could be in that clean channel and just hit that effects loop boost and live there. Like if you were Dave Grissom, and I reference Dave because I love his tones, you can almost live in the first channel and just use that boost, that second boost, and get almost everything and still get a great tone and get exactly what you want. For me, I would seldom use the super clean thing, but I would use the clean boosted some. That's kind of in my wheelhouse. And that second channel is slamming. So it doesn't have to necessarily be a hard rock amp. I'm getting blues rock tones. You can probably put a hotter pickup through that and get metal tones out of this amp. And I also noticed, and I'm sure you may have too, the noise floor is really low. It doesn't make a lot of residual noise. I mean, it's pretty darn quiet for the amount of gain we're producing with that amp. So we have it pretty cranked up in this room and my ears aren't ringing because the tones of this amp just don't hurt your ears. So we're gonna put all the contact information for Mr. Brown And that is real, his real name. It's funny, call it a Brown amp with all the people who met Brown, the Brown,
the Brown sound.
Yeah, and hit, this is the Brown sound, but it's from Mr. Brown right here in Texas. So guys, I'm happy we did this. This is a great demo. Check out his amps, give him a call, talk to him about it. You know, he's an up and coming builder and somebody that, you know, I think is gonna be happening. And the build quality on this thing is really, really cool. It's a beautiful, beautiful, really well built amp. Has a very interesting look about it. So once again, thanks to Brown for sending the amp down for us to check out. Thanks to Dr. Mike, as always, for the 57 Les Paul. I'm not giving this back to you anytime soon, dude. And thanks to Kurt for doing what Kurt does. So you guys have a great weekend. I'm saying weekend because we're shooting this on a Saturday morning. And we'll talk to you soon. I'm Lance. See y'all. Bye.